Hello student, today we will discuss the basic concept of electrical engineering. So just we start the introduction of electrical engineering. So when we talk about the electrical engineering, so first foremost condition is depend on the possibility of the value of voltage and current. So the most important terminology of electrical engineering is voltage and current. Then what is voltage? So the voltage, it is defined as the work done to transfer unit positive charge from infinity to any point in the electric field. So the voltage, it is defined as the work done to transfer unit positive charge from infinity to any point in the electric field. So in that case, the V is given by dW upon dq. So the voltage is given by work done per unit charge. So in that case, the unit of work done is given by joules and unit of charge is given by coulombs. So in another way, one volt is equal to the joule per coulomb. So it is also another definition of voltage. When we define one volt is equal to the one joule per coulomb, so the actual unit of voltage is volt. Now come to the concept of current. Then what is current? It is defined as the time rate of net motion of electric charge in any conductor. So, in other way, I is given by the dq upon dt. So we also say that the dq upon dt is coulomb per second. So the actual unit of current is ampere. So we can say that 1 ampere is equal to the 1 coulomb per second. So this is the basic formula related to the current. So 1 ampere is equal to the 1 coulomb per second. So now we identify the voltage. 1 volt is equal to the joule per coulomb and current 1 ampere is equal to the 1 coulomb per second. Now we identify the value of power. So power is given by V I and if we are consider the V dW upon dQ and I is equal to the dQ upon dt. So in another way, power is given by dW upon dt. So we all are aware, according to the Ohm's law, V equal to IR. So we can say that power is equal to the VI or I square R or V square by R. So this is the basic formula related to the power, and power is depend on the V into I, the voltage of V into I. So in a practical way, the VI is called as a real power, or the value of I square R and V square by R is called as a heat loss across the resistor. So when we calculate in a theoretical base, so quantity from the VI, quantity from the I square R and quantity from the V square by R is equal. When in a practical way, VI is the real power and I square R and V square by R is the heat loss across the resistor. So these are the basic concept of voltage, current and power. So now when we develop any circuit, so first essential condition is depend on the number of source which is used to deliver the power. So in the introduction of electrical engineering, source or power delivering capacity is given by voltage and current. So the source which is used to deliver the power is called as a voltage and current. So in that case, the voltage and current is also known as active element. So again, what is the definition of active element? An element which is used to deliver the power. An element just as an active element. An element which is used to deliver the power in a given circuit. So now the example of active element, voltage and current. Now the types of active element or types of source. So according to the concept, there are two types of sources. First is independent source, or second one as a dependent source. So independent sources classify into two category: voltage source and current source. The independent source, or the representation of independent source, positive negative terminal inside a circle. This is the representation of independent source, independent voltage source, and representation of independent current source, an arrow in inside a circle. So this is the basic representation of independent voltage source and current source. Now, the dependent sources classify into four category. Voltage dependent voltage source, current dependent voltage source, voltage dependent current source, and current dependent voltage source. Then what is the representation of different type of dependent source? So the representation of dependent source through a diamond shape. So the first one as a voltage dependent voltage source. So the voltage source, what is the representation of voltage source? It is just like a negative and positive terminal. So according to the condition of voltage source, inside a diamond shape we put as a negative and positive terminal. Then this voltage source is depend on the condition of another voltage. So we put alpha V. Here alpha is a numerical quantity or constant, maybe 2 volt, 3 volt, and so on. Another one, current dependent current source. Sorry, current dependent current source. So in that case, current dependent current source, again we draw the diamond shape. At this time the source is current source, so an arrow inside a diamond. Then depend on the current property, so alpha I. Another one, voltage dependent current source. So now as a current source, it is depend on the value of voltage, so alpha V. Or the last one, current dependent voltage source. So the now source is voltage, so positive and negative. It is depend on the property of current, so alpha I. So these are the two types of source in terms of independent source and dependent source. Voltage source and current source, then dependent source, voltage dependent voltage source, current dependent current source, voltage dependent current source, and current dependent voltage source. So these are the basic property of active element. Now come to the passive element. First part is complete, the basic properties of circuit. Then we deliver the power through the active element and the two types of active element in the terms of voltage source or current source. Now, what is the requirement to receive the power? So for receive the power, we always use R, L, and C. And this is called as a passive element. So first we deliver the power through the voltage source and current source. Another one, we receive the power through the R, L, C, which is also known as the passive element. So the first one as a resistance. It is a property of material which is used to oppose the flow of current. Resistance, it is a property of material which is used to oppose the flow of current. The unit of resistance is ohm. When two resistances are connected in series, so the equivalent resistance is given by R1 plus R2. If two resistances are connected in parallel, so in that case, R equivalent is equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Voltage across the resistor is given by V is equal to IR, and current across the resistor is given by I is equal to the V by R. So this is the basic property of resistance, which is also called as a passive element. Another passive element is inductance or inductor. So now, inductance, it is a property of material which oppose change of current. The unit of inductance is Henry. If two inductance are connected in series, L1 and L2, so the equivalent inductance is given by L1 plus L2. If two inductance are connected in parallel, so the equivalent inductance is given by L1 into L2 divided by L1 plus L2. Then voltage across the inductor, V is LdI by dt. Current across the inductor, 1 upon L integral of V dt. Inductor is always a energy storage element, and energy is given by 1 by 2 Li square. Inductance always store the energy in electromagnetic field. So these are the basic property of inductance. Now, come to the capacitance. It is a property of material which oppose change of voltage. It is a property of material which oppose change of voltage. If two capacitor are connected in series, so the C equivalent is given by C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Or if two capacitor are connected in parallel, so the C equivalent is given by C1 plus C2. The unit of capacitor is farad. Voltage across the capacitor is given by 1 upon C integral of I dt. Current across the capacitor I is equal to the CdV by dt. And capacitor is also an energy storage element. So energy is given by 1 by 2 CB square. Capacitor store the energy in electrostatic field. So these are the basic property of capacitor. So now we classify active element in the terms of voltage and current. Active element as a voltage and current, and passive element is R, L and C. Now some points keep in mind. Resistor always independent from time and frequency, and inductor and capacitor is depend on the time and frequency. So now we can define the circuit, because we already discussed the basic concept of active and passive element. So then what is the definition of circuit? It is a combination of active and passive elements. So this is the basic concept of circuit analysis, or the basic definition of circuit. Now we go through the property of circuit. Property of circuit. So the first one is the active and passive element. Second one, bilateral and unilateral property. Or the third one, linear and non-linear. So we already aware the basic concept of active and passive element. We already aware the concept of voltage, current, R, L and C. So now come forward about the bilateral and unilateral property. Then what is the property of bilateral? Current is flow any of the direction, and the example of bilateral element is R, L, C. So we understand the basic concept of bilateral property. For the example, we are consider as a 5 ohm resistance with respect to the 10 volt battery. Or the direction of current is clockwise. So in that case, the value of I is equal to the 2 ampere. In other example, 5 ohm is connected with 10 volt battery and direction of current is anti-clockwise. So in that case, I is equal to minus of 2 ampere. So that's mean we flow current either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. The magnitude of current is always same. The negative sign is so that we consider the current opposite to the direction of battery. So this property is called as a bilateral property, or an example of bilateral property is R, L, and C. Now come forward for the unilateral property. The example of unilateral property is diode, because in that case current is flow only in the single direction when diode is conducted in a forward bias. So this is the example of unilateral property. Now next property, as a linear and non-linear. Linear elements who obey the concept of Ohm's law, or the graphical representation of linear property, straight line from the origin. So the V and I, for the example, in the case of Ohm's law, V is equal to the IR. So when R is constant, so in that case V is directly proportional to the I. So if the value of I is equal to zero, so in that case V is also a zero. So the representation of linear element, just a straight line from the origin. So in another way, the linear element input is directly proportional to the output. Non-linear element who don't follow the concept of Ohm's law, or maybe representation between the two parameter, is hyperbola, or in a other way, or in a discrete manner. Rather than linear property, all the element is called as a non-linear element. So these are the basic property of circuit in terms of active element, passive element, bilateral and unilateral, linear and non-linear property. Now come to the first analytical concept of simplification of circuit. First one is a KCL and KVL, Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law. So first one, Kirchhoff's current law, KCL, the algebraic sum of current at any node is zero. It is based on the conservation of charge. Then what is the meaning of node? A point where more than two branches or more than two elements are connected, or a point from which current is distributed in a different direction. So first we consider a point as a node, and the direction of current may be incoming or outgoing. So we are consider as a I1 as a outgoing, I2 as a outgoing, I3 as a incoming, and I4 as a incoming. So according to the concept of KCL, incoming current is equal to the outgoing current. So according to that concept, I1 plus I2 is equal to the I3 plus I4. So this is the basic concept of KCL. Now come forward on KVL. The algebraic sum of of voltage in any closed path is zero. So in that case, if we are consider R1, R2 with respect to the supply of V and voltage across the R1 is V1 and voltage across the R2 is V2. So in that case, according to the concept of KVL, V is equal to the V1 plus V2. So the concept of KVL is depend on the conservation of energy. For the example, if we are consider 2 ohm resistance are connected in series with the 10 volt supply. So in that case, the value of current is equal to the 10 divided by 2 plus 2, 10 divided by 4 is equal to the 2.5 ampere. So in that case, the voltage across the 2 ohm V1 and voltage across the this 2 ohm is V2. So V1 is equal to the I into R. So 2.5 into 2 is equal to the 5 volt and V2 is equal to the 2.5 into 2 is equal to the 5 volt. So the finally 10 volt is equal to the 5 plus 5 volt. So this algebraic sum of voltage in any closed path is zero. So these are the basic concept of introduction of electrical engineering or principle of electrical engineering or basic electrical engineering in terms of the basic definition of voltage, current, resistance, inductance and capacitance. Then we create the property of circuit. Then we define the circuit. Then the basic concept of KCL and KVL.